मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट आवर टुडेज क्लास। ऑल स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 3, ओपन साइंस बुक चैप्टर 3। इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव लर्न्ड अबाउट बर्ड्स ऑफ बीक्स एंड फीदर्स ऑफ बर्ड्स। सो now today we will learn about feet and claws. So let us start this chapter, feet and claws of birds. Feet and claws of birds. Birds have 2 feet with 4 toes in each foot that end in a curved claws. Birds have 2 feet with 4 toes in each foot that end in a curved claws. They use their feet to move, hunt for food, and to protect themselves from enemies. They use their claws to catch food. Claws also help them to climb and sit on the branches of tree. Do you know, student? Dr. Saleem Ali is known as the Birds of Man of India. Now comes to flesh eating bird. Flesh eating bird. Birds of prey like eagle, vulture, and falcon have sharp and curved claws called talons, which are used to grip small animals like toad and rat while flying. Look at here, claws of an eagle, sharp and curved claws called talons. Now comes to perching bird. Perching birds. Perching birds like sparrow, crow, and mana have 3 toes in front. Look at here, 3 toes in front and one at the back. These toes help the birds to hold on firmly to the branch of the tree even while sleeping. Now comes to scratching bird. Scratching bird. Hens have strong legs with 3 toes in front and 1 at the back. Their toes have sharp, hard claws which help them to scratch and dig the ground in order to search out insects and breed seeds. Here, look at here. Claws of a hen. 3 toes in front and 1 at the back. Next, climbing bird. Birds like woodpecker and parakeets have 2 toes pointing forward and the other 2 pointing backward. These help them to climb and cling to trees. Claws of woodpecker. Swimming birds. Swimming birds. Feet of ducks and swan are joined by a soft and thin skin between the toes. This type of feet are called webbed feet. Look at here, claws of duck. This type of feet are claws webbed feet. Their webbed feet help them to push water backward while swimming. Now comes to bedding birds. Birds like herons and cranes, have long legs with spread out toes that help them wade. Wade means move. That help them wade through muddy and shallow water to catch their food, such as fish, insect and crabs. Now turn the page. Now comes to how does a bird fly? Look here, a bird flaps its wings to push through the air and rises up slowly into the air. Its wings make two types of movement, upward movement and downward movement. The upward movement is called upstroke and the downward movement is called downstroke. In an upstroke, the wings are thrown upward and backward, while in a downstroke, the wings are pushed downward and forward. The tail helps to change the direction of the flight. Look at here, the upstroke and downstroke movement. Some birds fly at a great height, like eagle and vulture. Sparrow fly very low. Birds like pigeon and crow can fly over long distance. Some birds can fly only short distance. For example, hen and peacock. Some birds cannot fly at all. They are called flightless birds, like ostrich and penguin, kiwi and emu. They are called flightless birds. Now, food habit. Birds' food habit. Birds eat their food with their beaks. They have different kinds of beak depending on their eating habit. Birds like parrot, sparrow, pigeon and hens eat insects, nuts, seed, fruits and grains. Birds like duck, herons, pelicans, penguin and kingfisher eat fish. Birds of prey like eagle, vulture and hawk eat the flesh of other animals. Woodpecker make holes in the trunk of the trees and catch small insects from there. Sunbirds and hummingbirds have a long and pointed beak to suck nectar from the flower. Students, do you know a hummingbird can flap its wings 90 times in just 1 second? So students, I hope you all have understand this chapter. It's all for today. Thank you. Stay home, stay fit.